assignment for this course allows you to implement the concepts of good test construction while reviewing for the final examination by writing a test of your own, focusing on the learning outcomes of the course listed in the syllabus. These slides give you the resources to review the elements of good test construction from the discussion and readings in the course and text. Using the backwards design reading in Session 7, decide what concepts you want to test. Remember, short answer questions generally test knowledge, and many definitions can be found in the review sheet posted in the readings for this session. Case studies ask students to apply that knowledge in new situations. Essay questions allow students to organize their thinking and what they have learned in the course. Therefore, higher order thinking skills measure not only knowledge, but application, understanding, and cause-effect relationships. Column 3 is self-explanatory. It is important to let a test taker know exactly what he or she is to do to complete the portion of the test correctly and be aware of how much each part of the test is worth. Checking former student models helps you get things right and clarify what you are to do. The graphic organizer helps those with spatial intelligence to visualize, organize, and simplify complex thinking and includes everything necessary to fulfill the assignment correctly. Make sure you have read each slide thoroughly so you can find previous assignments and explicit directions for completing each part of the graphic organizer. Reviewing qualities on which you will be assessed in the rubric is important to make certain you have completed all requirements and keep the grading transparent. This assessment will be attached to the lesson you post in the assignment area. This portion of the assignment allows you to reflect on the process of writing a test that reviews you for the final examination in this class. What were your difficulties in completing short answer and directed response questions? What did you have to consider in giving students directions? Why did you assign the point values you did to each portion of the exam? What did you learn about preparing students facing a summative assessment in your own or future classroom to make sure they were prepared to take the test? Step 6 elaborates exactly how to submit your work to the assignment area in Blackboard. Do not email it to me or post it in the discussion area, as your assignment grade will not be calculated in your class average, in my grade book, or the My Grades link to which you have access. If you have followed these step-by-step instructions explicitly, you should have completed the assignment with all its requirements. This is general information about where to locate instructions and assignments for each session of the class.